Good evening, Sweet World, and welcome to the Starters Night 6 Live from Samsung NBA Summer League at the Thomas & Mack Center in Las Vegas. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm J.E. Skeets, and alongside me, it is the international man of mystery, taking it to the max, Lee Ellis.
Friend.
Lee, Task Guys is attending to a family matter up in Toronto. Our thoughts and prayers are with you. We miss you, big guy. I can say, though, I'm happy to say, the bearded one, Trey Kirby, will be back on set tomorrow night.
Make sure you bring your best AO, everybody.
Bring your best AO. That's tomorrow night. Tonight, Rockets forward Sam Decker is going to join us live on set, so I'm looking forward to that. But first, let's take you through some highlights from day six here in Summer League. We start with the Kings and the Hawks. 12th overall pick, Taurean Prince, making an early impact. Hangos finds him. Prince for the let's go crazy dunk. And then Prince, he's going to use the screen, and he's going to make it purple rain from three.
Nice.
Taurean Prince killing it. We're not done. Thieves in the temple. Deep cut. Here we go. Prince the other way. Come on, pick it up. Pick it up, Prince. Let's go. Game blouses here in a second. Eddie Tavares with the dunk. All right. So in the third quarter, Sacramento's Isaiah Cousins gets to the rim, throws the hoop, sees the big man, Willie Cauley-Stein. Finishes home, 2015 draft pick, of course. In the third, DeAndre Bembry finishes it off, really, for Atlanta. Pangos to Bembry for the three-pointer. And then the Hawks, a little defense here. Nice to see at Summer League. Force the turnover, go the other way. In the end, Bembry's going to throw this one down. A nice dunk. Yeah. Nice. Let's take a look at that. Whoa. Bembry, 13 points, 5 boards, and a dime. Hawks win. Ka-ka, 81-61 in the blowout. Let's talk about that 12th overall pick, though, in Taurean Prince, because this is a guy, of course, that the Hawks traded for to get that pick and trading Jeff Teague in that three-way deal. What do you think?
And he showed the full bag of tricks on offense. It was diamonds and pearls, inside and outside, you know, going attacking the basket and knocking down the three-pointer. Also, got to the line 9 times and made all 9 of his free throws. So that's what I like to see about a guy is, if you're going to hit a three-pointer, that's fine, but don't fall in love with that jump shot when you're rookie. Make sure you show that you've got other parts to your game. And if you can do that, I think you're going to more likely impress your coach.
You can see why he was one of the more intriguing wings, at least, coming into this draft. And I'm not just saying this because he plays for the Hawks, but he does have a Damari Carroll vibe to him. Because he's locked in defensively, but he looks like he can still give you a little something on the offensive end.
And the Hawks could really use a guy like that as well, because they do miss Damari Carroll. So it's a good fit for that team. Whether or not he'll see minutes from the start, we don't know, but he's certainly been impressive so far.
All right, let's get to the Celtics and the Cavaliers. Jaylen Brown, number 3 pick overall. He had another great game, and we go right to the third. A little defense from here, steals the ball, takes it the other way for the fast break dunk.
Nice way to finish.
Last game, he had 20 and 10. Tonight, 25 points. This one close. In the third, though, there it is. Oh, man, he's got some hops. Jordan McRae, he gets it going for the Cavaliers. This guy has been putting up buckets here in Vegas.
Finally getting a chance, you know.
Hits the pull-up, knocks the three-pointer down, and then McRae gets into the paint. He's going to hit a tough, tough little follow-away jumper. He had 32 points, 82-80 for Cleveland. In the fourth, Kay Felder, not to be confused with Phil Elder, drives, hits the step back jumper. Pretty, pretty stuff. He had 22 points in the game. That's the Cavs' second round pick. In the fourth, less than a minute to go, Celtics down 3. Nadir takes it in. That's McRae playing defense. Take a look at this block. Perfectly timed.
He said nada to Nadir.
Get that out of here. Cavs win 98-94. I said it. Jordan McRae dominating. Yeah, poor Celtics fan. Sorry about that, big guy. It's just Summer League. Don't worry about it. Jordan McRae, though, again, 32 points in this one. He's been nearly averaging something like 23 in Vegas here.
Yeah, he's been really good here. He's in a tough spot, though, because there's just not enough minutes to go around in Cleveland. That's what happens when you're a deep rotation player on a championship team. It's great. You get the opportunity to experience what it's like going into the playoffs and playing with LeBron and Kyrie and Kevin Love. But the minutes simply aren't there. So when you do get your opportunity, you can see this guy's hungry to show that he can actually contribute.
He hasn't shot exceptionally well to get all those points, but he has a ton of free throws. 54 free throw attempts, Lee. That's your favorite stat.
The guy just keeps
getting there and getting there. Definitely attacking the rim. All right. Continuing with the highlights from day 6. Bucks and Mavs, Thon Maker. This guy dominating here at the Thomas & Mack Center and Cox Pavilion. shows off a little bit of everything, especially
the
range.
That's a pretty shot he's got.
I know,
right,
he's
there.
Got a very nice release a little later in the first. Thon hits the three. This was a theme in this game. Second quarter, Thon maker. Yeah, a little step back three.
Step back swoosh from a 7-3 guy. It's amazing.
17 points in the game in the second half. It was all Mavs. Third quarter, AJ Hammonds, 46th pick overall. He cut it down, threw it down. And then Perry Ellis in the post, sinks the little baby hook. And again, sticking with the Mavs. Vander Blue gonna drive baseline here. Yep, see ya for the pretty reverse lay-in. Mavs win 81-64. Thonmaker, though, it came in a loss. Again, it doesn't really matter. Yeah. Summer League, congrats, of course, to the Mavs moving on. But Thonmaker for the Bucks. This guy, when he got drafted as high as he did at number 10, people said, who?
Yeah.
What? Bit of a stretch? He probably was going to go later, but he's shutting a lot of people up here early.
He is. I mean, those shots we saw him making there, they're swishing through as well. These aren't rattling in. He's got a very nice stroke. He's very confident in the way he shoots the ball. And when you're that tall and you've got that high release, it's like Kevin Durant. It's very, very difficult to block.
It's next to impossible.
Yeah, and even if you get a hand in his face, if he works on that release, he knows he can get a good shot off. And again, you're seeing a step back. He's putting on the floor and then stepping back and knocking down the three-pointer. If you're a Bucks fan, you've got to be very excited with what you're seeing.
Yeah, you're hoping that what happened when they took Yanni way back when, and people said, who, what, sort of pans out in something similar.
They're
with
certainly going to be the longest limbs in the league, those two guys.
Crazy.
And John Henson as well.
Yeah, all right, let's take you through the rest of the highlights here. From day six in summer, we go Blazers and Mavs. Trey Lyles not playing, unfortunately, in this one after having a great game last night. But for the Blazers, Noah Vonleh hits the jumper, deep jumper. Utah up 15-12. Then in the third, Pierre Jackson is going to find Vonleh for the dunk. 10 points in the game overall for that Blazers guy. Pierre Jackson, oh man, this guy's fast. Steals it, lays it in on the break. He had 18 points in the third, though. Aaron Kraft misses. Joel Balumbo, Balumboy, one of the young boys, Balumboy, rebounds, dunks it emphatically. Tough name there. He had a great game, though. Drop steps, throws it down, 14 points, 5-6 shooting, 9 boards. In the fourth, Tibor Pleiss makes the very pretty left-handed hook. And then a little bit more. He's going to show the range. Can everyone hit a three-pointer in today's game? I think so. Terry Allen finds him, and he hits that. He had 20 points on 6-9 shooting. Utah wins 86-71. Buddy Hield and the Pelicans taking on the Heat. Had the offense going early. And not just shooting, drive kicking. Larry Drew the second for three. Back to Hield. Drives. Hits the floater. Yeah, very nice. Oh, a little dinker and dumper there, actually. Shout out to Tim Duncan in the fourth. Shaq Diallo, 33rd overall pick. He's continuing to play well here. Gets it down low, hits the jumper. 14 points, 12 boards for him. In the fourth, back to Buddy Hield, laying it in.
Beautiful.
Nice.
Switching hands through there.
Then Buddy Hield knocked down the deep three there. 16 points, took 17 shots to get there. Zach Lowe's not going to like that efficiency, but keep shooting, buddy. In the fourth, Miami makes a comeback. Hield turns it over. Briante Weber hits the three on the other end. And then a little more Weber. He's going to miss this one. It's all right. The big man there, O'Carroll White, is there for the putback.
Nice finish.
Heat win, 81-77. And just quickly here with the Rockets and Warriors. 2 minutes left. Game tied. Patrick McCaw to Darian Atkins for the layup. Warriors up two. This was a very, very close game. Very fun game. And then under 30 seconds to go, Warriors still up two. Montrezl Harrell blocks.
Oh, yeah.
Blocks Patrick McCaw at the rim. Houston with a chance here. Oh, McDaniels turns it over, and the Warriors hang on to win 80-76.
He's another active guy.
James Harden. James Harden absolutely, absolutely loves it. Yeah, yeah. Beverly, yeah, we all saw it, man. We saw it. We were all watching. All right. Here's a look at the Las Vegas Summer League tournament bracket. You see the eight matchups there in the second round. Those will be our games tomorrow. So can't wait for that. We got to take a break. Lots more still to come on tonight's episode. It starts a little bit later in the show. Sam Decker of the Rockets will join us here. And we're going to talk about these new, if you want to call them that, Hacker Shack rules. Come on back. No, hey, unfortunately not. The real TK will be here tomorrow.
The fans are dying for Trey to come back
on
set.
They're just dying for Ayo. You're absolutely right. All right, guys, a little bit later in the show, as I said, Rockets forward Sam Decker is going to join us. Can't wait for that. But first, NBA Commissioner Adam Silver, he addressed the media yesterday following the Board of Governors meeting. He discussed a number of topics, including additional Hack-a-Shaq regulations. I believe we have a clip.
We had a discussion about so-called Hack-a-Shaq. In essence, the rule is now that the last two-minute rule that's been in effect for almost 40 years now is now in effect for the last 2 minutes of every quarter. And in addition, we wanted to ensure that players would not be jumping on other players' backs, as we've seen and during free throws. So we made it clear that that would be presumptively a flagrant foul if that were to happen.
So there you hear it. Basically taking away another 6 minutes where a team would really want to do it, because mm-hmm. why would you? If you foul, the team getting a free throw and they're getting the ball back. Do you think, though, that the league did enough right now to sort of get rid of this whole Hack-a-Shaq stuff?
No, but I think Adam Silver's in a tough spot because he hasn't got the power to just go out there and change rules whatever he wants. He has to find a compromise that the owners all agree on. And I think some of the owners just hate it and they despise this tactic, but some of them feel like, you know what, I don't like it either, but I still need to want to have it, my team to have that option if it's needed, because there are so many now awful free throw shooters who spend a lot of time on the court. So I think this is the first step, and I think if it doesn't improve still, and the league claims it will reduce incidents by 45%, but if we don't see an improvement, I think this is the first step, and then next season we'll see a further improvement.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. Maybe the problem here was we just couldn't eliminate it altogether.
Yeah.
But that's what I hope happens. That needs to happen because, yeah, they throw out that, oh, it should reduce it by 45%. Why is that the case? Because wouldn't coaches now just start going to it earlier?
Yeah.
We've seen, there was a, what was it? A January game where the Rockets fouled Andre Drummond 12 straight times to start the third quarter.
Yeah.
Not near the end of the third quarter, not near the end of the second, at the start.
And that's crazy.
So that's going to happen.
There's no doubt that's an ugly part of the game that we have to watch. But again, these guys do have to improve their free throws. I know that's not the only solution out there, but you can't have guys spending that much time on the court shooting 35% from the free throw line. There's got to be some improvement there as well, and they have to be held accountable for that.
Lee, when that guy who shoots 35% gets the ball, you can foul him and send him to the line.
Yes.
It is this situation where a guy is running 80 feet to go bear hug a guy, and it looks nothing like basketball.
No, and I get that.
That's the problem.
I know that that's the problem, but as well, it does fall on these guys as well to just make free throws, improve your free throws. It can't be that difficult that you're shooting that badly.
I've seen Dan Feldman at NBC Sports. I thought he had a great line about this. He says, hacking is the only skill that I can execute, and I'll put myself in there at an NBA level. Yeah. It's the only thing I could possibly do. Go up and wrap a guy up, and that's it. And I'm amazing at it, just like everyone else.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, then that's not an NBA skill
right.
we want.
But if you're playing against an opponent, and they have a weakness, no matter what that weakness is, you are allowed to exploit it.
That's what coaches are doing.
Yeah. So.
Okay, but I'm also a fan that watches the games. We don't need them any longer. I think we can agree with that.
No.
We don't need them any uglier. And I know you love free throws, but I don't need to watch more free throws.
I don't like watching a guy shoot 30% from the free throw line. But again, I think Adam Silver's in that tough spot because he can't just go out there and wipe it out altogether.
So you think this might be a little baby step?
This is a tester as well. And you have to please all the owners. And it's very difficult to please all those people all the time.
So what might happen then, it's possible, I guess, is if coaches adapt to these new rules, continue to hack, then maybe we start to eliminate it completely.
Then the next step could be taken where you either increase the timeline or you just change the punishment so that if you hack away from the ball at any time, it's possession after free throws.
Why don't you just teach all these guys to shoot free throws? Hire Lee Ellis.
Yeah.
He'll teach you how to
Square
shoot free
shoulders,
throws. Let us know what you guys think. Let us know what you think on Twitter, hashtag the starters. When we come back, yeah, that's right, Wisconsin's finest Houston Rockets forward Sam Dekker will join us live on Sit Hunt. Triple Decker, we're joined now by Houston Rockets forward Sam Dekker. Sam, thanks for joining us, man.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Really,
good to be on.
And if you want to say hi to your mom, I know you texted her right before you came on here.
Hey, Mom.
There you go. Hopefully she's watching. I asked him, why isn't she always watching? I don't know. Come on, Mom. First off, how excited are you just to be playing here at Summer League after the season you went through last year with the back surgery?
Yeah, it feels really good. I didn't even play Summer League last year,
right?
So this is... you know, got a few games of preseason and then a few games during like beginning of the year and then
yeah.
I was done.
Yeah.
So
I think you played three in the NBA season, like something like seven in the D League, and that was it, yeah.
Yeah, that's that's about all I did. And so right now I'm kind of working the kinks out, and you know, I had a few good games starting. I'm just trying to push through this week, and but I'm enjoying it, having fun, and just trying to knock that rust off, like I said.
What did you learn from watching the game? Because you've played it through your whole life, and then you're playing college, and then you get to the NBA, it's your dream, and then all of a sudden it's kind of taken away from you. What did you learn from watching?
Yeah, you had to kind of step away and, you know, understand, you know, some things, and you got to realize that it's better to get this out of the way early in my career, because, you know, there's a long road, and, you know, God willing, I have a very long career coming up. So get that out of the way, and then just kind of mentally take in the game as much as possible, be around the vets as much as you can, and so I saw some things I liked, some things I didn't like, and how to be a pro, and so I learned a lot. I can already tell that I'm a step ahead right now, and essentially, if you can kind of look at it, going into my second butt rookie year, you know, just learn on the fly and take it all in.
Yeah, we've heard some guys, like exactly what you said, how it can be almost beneficial in a weird way, at least early, to sort of, as you said, take it in.
Yeah.
See it from a different perspective, so that's great to hear. The Rockets had a busy offseason.
Yeah,
you guys got a different team, Ryan Anderson.
New staff.
Eric Gordon, new staff, and Coach D'Antoni. I guess, well, let's ask about that. Have you had a chance to talk to Coach D'Antoni?
Yeah, he's been around since we hired him. You know, he's been around every day at our workouts. You know, I've been down there, you know, since the first week of May, because, you know, me being hurt, they wanted their hands on me, you know, see how I'm progressing and everything. So we've had a chance to talk, you know, the whole staff, and I'm excited with, you know, the direction we're going, and you know, his free-flowing offense, and, you know, push the ball, but you know, but under control. But there, you know, there's gonna be a lot of opportunities for myself and our whole team to really be tough to match up with. We got a lot of weapons, and, you know, I'm excited for what we have.
What sort of goal or expectation have you set for yourself? I mean, you want to be in that starting lineup?
Everyone wants to start, but, you know, I just want to crack that rotation and be a big help to this team, because, you know, I have, you know, some ability that can, you know, be a difference maker, you know, with my, you know, size and athleticism and my skill set. Yeah, I'm just trying to show Houston and the staff and my teammates that they can trust me, and I can be an asset for this team, and, you know, hopefully make a championship run.
Well, we were very excited when we heard you were coming on the show for a number of reasons, but a big one is that you're one of the best follows on social media in the NBA.
Yeah, good and bad.
I'm talking Twitter, Instagram, but we did come across some photos on your Instagram account that we were either A, very confused by, or B, we just wanted more of the story.
Yeah.
So we thought it'd be a perfect time to play a little game called Explain That Gram with Sam Decker. So we're going to show you one of your Instagram pics. These are your Instagram pics, and you can break it down for us and fill us in on any backstory with it.
Okay.
Love this first one. Love this first one, because I'm very confused by it. Here it is. It's an interesting way to ride a scooter, a two-man scooter. What's going on here?
That's Zach Schull out there, my roommate and best friend from school. He's also on the team, but I don't know what I was really doing. We're waiting for something, and you know, when boredom comes into play as a college kid, you come up with all new things. So
I did laugh. This is a throwback Thursday pick. I did laugh quite hard at the hashtag Bound 2, though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the Bound 2 from the music video.
So does that make you Kanye in that photo, or Kim? I can't tell.
I'll be Kanye.
Fair enough. All right. Our next pick here. Again, this is Sam Decker, Instagram pick. What's going on?
I don't even. Oh, I remember. That is. I was getting a. I don't even know what it's called. That was for a mouth guard.
Okay, right, that's what we thought. That's what we sort of thought.
Yeah,
okay.
And that scans the inside of your mouth.
Right.
So it's very exact.
Is that a selfie, or have you got someone there taking that for you?
That was a selfie.
Wow.
That's pretty talented.
Can do it all. Good stuff. All right, our next one here. I think you're going to like this one. It's a selfie pic.
My homie.
With your homie, your puppy there.
Yeah.
How long have you had this dog?
That's Riggins,
okay.
Got him in December. Oh, I miss him.
Yeah.
he's back in Houston,
okay.
But he's doing good. He's with his trainer, working hard.
But he was, I just read a story, I think it was by Calvin Watkins. He was a big part of your recovery, right?
Yeah, so that was after a game. And, you know, it win or lose, you know, it sucked. You know, being in a suit and just not being able to play. So, you know, he kept me busy, kept my mind off, you know, the whole situation and everything. And you can see he's a cutie.
Oh, look at those eyes, man.
He's a husky. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Look at the blue eyes. All right, next picture here. Again, this is from Sam Decker's account. Go on. Explain this one.
That's Frank.
Frank, right?
That's us in a nutshell right there. love keeping it loose and hanging out. He looks pretty buff there. But
yeah, he looks good.
Yeah. Whose idea was it to do this? You can throw Frank under the bus.
So we don't like have ideas. Things just happen. Yeah. The more spontaneous, the more fun you have. So that was us. Plus that, all those rookie photo shoots get a little boring.
Fair enough.
Bring some life into it.
Yeah, you got to blow that one up. Frame that one. All right, a final one here. Again, explain that gram with Sam Decker. It's the Biebs.
Biebs.
How'd this happen?
I was in the gym. Getting a good workout in, and he walks in with a dog and a security guard, and I guess he comes into my workplace and takes over, and the coaches go with him and give him a little workout.
Oh, wow.
And I'm like,
okay, well, I gotta ask, did you play him one-on-one at all? Did you get crossed over by the Biebs?
No.
Did this happen? Did this happen?
We played 2-on-2. It was him and Tyson Chandler. It was the day after we played the Suns. It was him and Tyson Chandler against me and Donatus Mateunas.
Okay.
We played 2-on-2, and then we played Lightning.
Awesome.
And I won.
Oh, okay. Look, Sam, we can't thank you enough. We're giving you, instead of a cake, a bone for Riggins. He's a little small right now. Guys, give it up for Sam Decker. Thank you so much. We're going to take one more break. When we come back, we'll put a bow on Night 6 in Summer League. Quick WNBA highlight here. The Los Angeles Sparks defeated the Chicago Sky today to improve to 19-1 on the season. LA is now one win shy of the best start in WNBA history, originally set by Cynthia Cooper. Cheryl Swoops on the 98 Houston Comets. LA will try to tie the Comets record for the best start ever on Friday against the Sun in a battle of the Ogumake sisters on League Pass. But if the Sparks win Friday, they'll go for 21-1 on Sunday against Atlanta on NBA TV, 3 p.m. Eastern Time. All right, Lee, who gets your honor for very solid play?
It comes from the 76ers and D-League game. It's Timotei Luwawu-Cabaret to Alex Caruso. And then Brian Allen finishes with a beautiful layup. Here it is again. Look at this no-look bounce pass. Beautiful finish. That's what I call a very solid play.
Yes, great stuff. Great stuff. All right, guys. A thing we'd really like to squeeze in here if we have the time. We do? That's good. Pokemon Go is currently all the rage, and that includes here in Vegas. Jazz center Rudy Gobert got in on the fun a few nights ago while he was courtside at a Summer League game, and a wild Spearow appeared. Right there on the floor, setting up for a corner three. The Frenchman captured it, I guess.
Of course he did. He's Pokemon Go Bear.
Oh, man. So congrats to him. Let's take a quick look at the Samsung NBA Summer League upcoming schedule for Thursday, July 14th. Hawks, Wizards, Heat Suns, Jazz Nuggets. Will there be another Pokemon Go on the clock? Who knows? And Warriors, Raptors. Raptors, the number one seed right now.
Give me some Raptors
here at Summer League. Yeah, go Raptors. We're going to put the banner up in the ACC if the Raps win Summer League. All right, that's it for us. We'll be back tomorrow night at the end of it all. Thanks to these guys for joining us. We'll see you soon. We do love Vegas. Very much so. Grace the night, people.